Kickers, what's going on? Is it too humid? Huh? It's really gross outside. It's gonna storm too, isn't it, huh? Gonna storm, get all wet and gross out. Scary Jerry outside. Huh? You don't like it? You're falling asleep, aren't you, huh? What's going on with you, She's literally falling asleep in the cross ties. That's how disgusting and humid it is right now. So, anyway, I think that I'm going to have to say goodbye here. But KK wanted to say hi. And she knows I have more treats for her. Which is KK, huh? There you go. I got those ears to come forward. Say goodbye to everybody. Bye-bye.
I love democracy. I love the Republic.
The main thing is to protect these characters. Make sure that they still continue to live in the way that you created them. And that the universe of Star Wars continues to grow.
Somewhere in 2012, after George Lucas sold Lucasfilm, somebody at Lucasfilm convinced Bob Iger that if they took a female character, made her the hero, that boys would be interested and buy the merchandise, and they would get the girls too. Don't know who it was, let's just assume it was Kennedy, since she was the font of the ruination of Galaxy's Edge and so many other things. The reason why I'm bringing this up now is because WDW Pro, that Park Place, got an email from an insider that deals with the toys, action figures, and he was basically mostly talking about Marvel, but he did mention Lucasfilm and how forcing Rey, and not just forcing Rey, in my opinion, it's not just Rey by herself. It's the way she was written. It's the fact that she doesn't appeal to anybody because she's perfect. Okay. This picture, by the way, is the last one I took at Ollie's a week ago. And if I go there tomorrow, it'll probably be the same. These figures, they go all the way up to the top of the shelf. They have not changed in a year. This is what's left over from the big Christmas buyout. And I'm going to assume that the reason why so many of the other toys were sold and why a lot of it did get sold was collectors bought in gross and then just shoved them away in tubs, hoping that they would someday accrue value. Good luck on that. No one wants these. But these have been sitting on pegs at Ollie's for close to a year, if not a year. Okay? So just to understand that I have been seeing what, and this is a video that I took earlier. You can see Rey figures and Rey from The Last Jedi, or The Force Awakens. It's just, you know, what this person who wrote the email to WDW Pro is saying is what I've been saying. And they get this girl out there. No one likes her. She's terribly written, terribly acted. She's basically worthless. And these videos were taken over time. Okay. And because sequel trilogy characters are not selling. They're trying to balance it out with classic characters. And now it's hurting the classic characters. Okay. Again, it is not that there's a lot of Star Wars, because there isn't right now. There's a lot of bad Star Wars, okay? And Disney was so bold in wanting to get into grabbing the boys' market that they didn't realize that they can't effeminize the boys. If a girl wants to hang out and do Star Wars, she's going to hang out and do Star Wars, okay? But most girls, when I was a kid, did not like Star Wars. They did not want to do that. They were into Barbie. They were into just all this other stuff. Holly Hobby and the Sunshine Family, I think that was one of the other things. Things like that. They're not into adventures, action figures, even though, you know, an action figure is a doll. But what I'm saying here is that WDW Pro proves my point. His contact is proving my point that Kennedy saying we can get both the girls and the boys and still have a female heroine was wrong. And Disney, of course, is paying for that poor decision making because they're not, the licensees aren't selling these things. And now Rey is dragging down Luke, Han, Vader, of all people, Boba Fett. And it's not, and it's, but it's just not her. It's the poor storytelling. It's the fact that, again, the contagion of social justice, that Lyme's disease of political bullshit, has infected Star Wars to the point where they can't sell what they should have been able to sell easily to a market. And again, it is not too much Star Wars. There isn't enough Star Wars. There's no really good Star Wars out there, okay? And even if it is good, because of who is running the company, people think, their names are on products. And when I say product, I'm not just talking about books or action figures or ships or models, comic books. Talk about the shows. Star Wars is not a theatrical franchise right now. And it would be doing very well, I think, because Kenobi was good. I don't think, you know, the big channels would have anything to bitch about if a certain name was off the producer's list, if a certain name disappeared from the leadership list at Lucasfilm, and that name is Kathleen Kennedy, okay? If you want to look at why this merchandise isn't selling, go look and see what she said about Galaxy's Edge to Bob Iger. That is a true story. A former vice president at Disney admitted she went to Iger and said, we have more movies ahead of us than behind us. Don't use the original trilogy for Galaxy's Edge. Okay. So when I look at the Rey character, poorly written, poorly acted, she's basically an avatar of how feminists view all women. We don't, I mean, I doubt she even has a period. That's how perfect she does. And if she is. And if she does, she doesn't have cramps. She doesn't feel bloated. She's the perfect human being. And, you know, when Doomcock says the best is Ivar, there you go. This did not endear Rey to the little boys, okay? Did not endear Rey to girls either. Okay, girls, again, there are girls out there who will play with Star Wars. I did. Who will do Star Wars. I did. But the vast majority won't. And trying to take Rey and get her as the bait to bring those girls who play with Barbie, who play with, you know, tea and baby dolls, and, you know, they've got their Princess Elsa toys and everything. They're not going to go with Rey. They're not, because Rey is not a princess. She is not something that attracts femininity in that way. I think the only characters, female characters in Star Wars that are up on screen are Leia and Padme, because they were royalty, okay? They were feminine, okay? And that's what drew me to Star Wars, okay? You could be a princess and be a badass, okay? You can be a queen and be a badass, okay? And that, basically, there you go. Rey doesn't have any feminine qualities, so she's not going to bring the girls in. Well, maybe girls like Molly Damon, okay? But Molly Damon really isn't a girl. She's an it. But they're not going to bring the girls that like the princess toys, okay? And they're not going to bring the girls who love Star Wars in, because we're repelled by Rey. We are repelled by Holdo. We are repelled by, you know, the female characters in the High Republic. We are repelled by Aphra. Okay? So, this is the problem. And the boys won't touch him with a 10-foot pole. All right? Because how does a boy identify with a misandrist icon like Aphra? Or Rey, in fact. Kids inherently know when they're being looked down on. They do. They can figure it out. This is why the merchandise sales aren't going well. Collectors don't want Rey. They don't want Kylo Ren either. And the expert that contacted Pro proved my point. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.